This conference will now be recorded.
Yeah. Hello, guys. We from Data Platform Trainings provide training on different Microsoft technologies. Microsoft SQL Server, Microsoft Azure SQL, Microsoft Power BI, Microsoft Business Intelligence, SSIS, SSRS, and SSCS. Today, I would like to talk on what is resource group in Azure? What does this mean in Microsoft Azure? When you go for a resource group is nothing but it's a collection of assets in logical group for easy or even automatic provision, monitoring, and access control for more effective management of their costs. On one of the benefit of using resource group in Azure is grouping related resources that belong to application as together, as they are a unified life cycle from creation to usage and finally for deprovisioning. Means what does that mean here is resource group in Azure means it's nothing but a collection. It acts as a collection of resource in one container or as a logical group. And why do we go for resource group is it's acts as a logical container for all the resource that you create. Okay, and we'll see how you create a resource group and why do we require this resource group. For instance, I'll tell you a single example for this. For instance, if application requires different resource that need to be updated together, such as having SQL Server database, a web application, a mobile application, etc., then it makes sense to group all these resources in same resource group. It is important, however, to use different resource group for dev, testing, staging, or production, as the resource in this group have different life cycles. Let's see in detail what is resource group. Let me open the notepad. Okay, yeah, I'll talk what is resource group here. As I told you, resource group is a logical container or logical group for a set of resource. Okay, what does this mean? Okay, let's see. Assume example, now in real time you work on different environments, right? One is dev and other is UAT, right? And other is SAT and fourth one is prod, right? And dev we call this is user assessment test, right? And this we call as system integrated test, right? And this is called production environment. Okay, right. Now what we do is we need to develop some application. Assume you are trying to develop an application. Example, we are trying to develop an web application, right? Web application in Visual Studio, right? So what are the resources that are required now? One resource is Microsoft Visual Studio, okay? And we require the second one, we required Microsoft SQL Server, okay? And we required some, assume you required some web jobs also, like this, assume, etc., if you require. So what we do is we require all these three resources in different environments. So instead of creating and leaving all these resources, what we do, we create a resource group called, we create a resource group with dev, okay, UAT, SAT, and prod like this. So whatever the resource that are available, or the resource that are used for dev, all the resource we used for dev, we will place it in dev folder. That is nothing but dev resource group. Okay, and similarly, all the resource used for UAT, we will place it in UAT resource group. Why do we do like this? Is it is easy to manage, comma, monitor and deprovision. As I told you, deprovision nothing but deallocating the resource once the work is completed. Now we will see a demo how to create a resource group. Let's go and see now in Azure. Before you create, we need to have the prerequisite. We need to have Azure subscription with you. Okay, and don't worry about the subscription. Microsoft is providing you this Azure subscription for a trial of Microsoft is providing you free trial Azure subscription for a period of 28 days with $200 credit limit. Okay, that means it is valid for how long this Azure subscription is valid. It is valid for 28 days or $200 whichever is earlier. What does it mean, whichever earlier? It means like if you have 28 days is expired, but still you have the US dollars limit, credit limit is left, or 28 days is left, still pending, but the credit limit of $200 is completed, then your free trial subscription will be decomposed. Means it's nothing but you are going to get deactivated. Okay, this is what is going to happen. Don't worry, you can do it with using Hotmail or Outlook email ID. And to create this subscription, what you need to have is one credit card, and next thing you need to provide a PAN card, and third one is you need to have Outlook or Hotmail mail ID. These three are required to create your Azure subscription. Okay, now let's see what is resource group. As I told you, resource group is nothing but a logical container or logical group of resource which can be bundled in single entity. It is easy to monitor, manage, and deprovision the resource. It acts as a logical container of the resource. Okay, right. Let's go. What I'll do? I'm logged into this Azure portal. Okay. Once you logged in, you will log in. Just go type Azure portal, azure.portal.com. Okay. Because it has got directly into logged into the dashboard, but when you type portal.azure.com, it will ask for the credentials, because I've saved the credentials, so it has directly come to the portal main page, that is dashboard. Okay, right. Now we'll create a resource group. How do you create a resource group? Is either you click on create resource group on the top with plus symbol, or here you have a resource group here. Okay, let's go and click on the resource group. Click on new resource here. Click on new resource. Click on here, create resource, or click on resource group. Let's click on resource group in the favorites, because some of the items or some of the resources are predefinedly added to your favorites. Okay, you can also add your own favorites to this favorite list. Okay, right. Let's click on resource group here. Click on resource group. It will show you all the resources already existing with you. I have already have test UAT a two resource group. Okay, I want to create a new resource group. So now when you clicked on the resource group, it has taken to a new blade, nothing but a new tab, or you can say new window, right? Click on add button here. Click on add. Okay, now it has taken to different tab. Now what is it asking? It is asking for the resource group name, subscription, and resource group location. Let's go here. I'll give some name, rg-def. Okay, rg-def. And its subscription is, because we are using free subscription, so you will be able to see only free trial. Now then it is asking for resource group location. It's nothing but, what is a resource group location here? It's nothing but, these are all the places where Microsoft has its own data center. If you go for Australia, Canada, Brazil, these are nothing but data centers where Microsoft Azure is available. These are all the data centers where Microsoft Cloud is available. Okay, select, because I'm taking the South India. Just take and just click on create, so that resource group will get created. Okay, and the name that we have taken is mark with green, means that name is available, you can take it. Okay, right, click on create here. Now it got created, pin to dashboard here. Okay, just pin to dashboard. That means it will be added to your dashboard. Now you were having RG test, RG UAT, right? Just refresh this. Now you are able to see the RG iPhone test. Just click on this. Okay, just what do you, RG iPhone test, did you, right? Sorry, we have created RG dev, right? Click on RG dev. Now you don't have any of the resource created here under this RG resource group. Okay, whenever you are creating, it will ask you the resource group, so we should give that resource group name. So whatever the resource that you create will be, whatever the resource that you create and you provide the resource, that resource will be bundled to that resource group. Okay, thank you for watching this video. I would request you to subscribe azuresqltraining@gmail.com, or you can subscribe data platform trainings in YouTube channel, and please forward this information to your friends, so that they will be also able to learn the new things and knowledge that I've been sharing on the YouTube portal. Thank you so much, guys. Thank you for attending and going through my video. Thank you, guys.